All right, what's going on today, YouTube? Welcome back to your favorite cyclist YouTube channel and this week's Bike Quick Talks. So what are we talking about today? Well, today we're talking all about oval chainrings versus round chainrings. Talking about what the big difference is and if you should get a oval chainring or if you should just stick with your plain old round chainring. But before we get into today's video, if you are new to my channel, make sure you head down below, hit that subscribe button for me. Appreciate having you guys on the channel. And if you already are subscribed, make sure you hit that little bell icon next to that. That way you get notified every time I upload. So don't miss any of these awesome bike quick talks, reviews, tech tips, any cool cycling videos we do on this channel, you don't wanna miss. So looking into oval chainrings, what is the deal with an oval chainring? So oval chainrings, I've heard about them for a long time. If you are into any kind of cycling, sometime or another you've heard of oval chainrings. So what's the deal with them? Well, we'll go ahead and start with just your standard chainring here. So this is actually an old chainring off of the Superfly from when it was a 3x on the front. And as you can tell, pretty much a straight up circle. That's it. There is no, it's just a circle. Pretty simple. So circle, generally you pedal, you're getting the same tension throughout the whole pedal stroke as you're going around because it's a circle. There's no difference to it. So go ahead and look at a oval chainring here. This is actually one that's made by Snail is the company. And pretty much you look at it, and that's actually, it is an oval shape to it. So it is an oval. So pretty much how it works is where you position this pretty much on your downward stroke and the upward stroke, where you're gonna be getting the most power out of your strokes. You're gonna be on the long sides of this oval. It's gonna make pedaling a little bit easier versus the kind of short sides here on the ends. How does that work exactly? Magic. That's how it works. No, I'm kidding. It doesn't work by magic. Come on. A lot of these oval companies will tell you it works by magic, but it doesn't. So pretty much how it works is you put the position this onto your chain ring. See, let me find the arrow. There we go. Like so. So pretty much as you can tell, I'll go ahead and hold these two up to each other here because this makes it really easy to see the big difference between them. There we go. So as you can probably see there, the biggest difference, you can see that the oval chainring is a lot bigger on the long sides, and on the short sides, it's actually a little smaller, honestly, is what it is. The teeth on this Snail one are huge versus this this multi-gear chainring here. So that's gonna be the biggest difference there. So it is an oval chainring. It's not a fake thing. Coming up in my next video, that's gonna be on this channel, I'm actually gonna be installing this oval chainring on the Superfly here. That way you can actually test and see if an oval chainring actually makes any kind of a difference to riding at all, or whether you should just stick with a straight up just circle chainring, and whether an oval chainring is actually worth your money. So that's gonna be the biggest thing there. You're gonna be getting a little bit less of a resistance on your down and up strokes, therefore making it easier where you're getting the most power out of your stroke. And then on the spots where you're just kind of pedaling through, it's just gonna be nice coasting about the same size as just a standard chainring. So does it make a difference or not? You'll have to stay tuned to this channel when we throw it on the Superfly here, go for some rides. I'll give you guys a long-term review, see if the oval chainring actually makes a difference. So stay tuned, coming out on Thursday, we'll go ahead and have a video coming out all about installing this oval chainring, getting this on this bike, seeing if I notice an immediate difference to it. And once it's on the Superfly, we'll go ahead and do a long-term test on this, see if an oval chainring actually is worth the money. And we'll see if there's any difference over just a standard circular chainring here. So hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up. Appreciate the support. Any comments or questions, let me know down in the comments section below. Love hearing from you guys. Love answering any questions you guys have about oval chainrings. And we'll see you on the next video. Thanks for watching today.